Hello friends, this video on NEET Ecology is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Let's talk about biodiversity hotspot. So what do we mean by hotspot? So these are those spots which are also known as ecological hotspots. Why? Because they have high diversity of species and threatened with destruction. So you think, see both the things together at the same place. Like first thing is they are like the richest reservoirs of plant and animal life. So you would see n number of species of plants and animals in these regions, but at the same time these regions would be the most threatened regions where the animals are threatened either because of hunting, deforestation or environmental conditions. So whatever the reason may be, but the plant and animal species in these areas are very highly threatened. So both the things, like first is they should be the richest reservoirs of plant and animal life. At the same time, they should be the most threatened regions. So most threatened plus high diversity of species. So if both these criteria are met for a particular region, then that region is called biodiversity hotspot. So biodiversity means diversity of living organisms. So biodiversity hotspot, because it is a hotspot because it needs a lot of attention, because it is also facing it is kind of that organisms in that area are also threatened. Now when we say threatened, what do we mean? Threatened means that maybe those organisms are endangered, that is they can become extinct. There is a high possibility that those organisms, whether it is plant or animal, that they can become extinct, and there could be several reasons for extinction. So that is known as threatened. Now in order to be a biodiversity hotspot, because you might see huge number of forests and wild areas where large variety of living organisms live. So can we categorize all of them as biodiversity hotspot? How do we know which is a biodiversity hotspot and which is not? Now primarily there are two criteria which needs to be met for a particular region to be called as a biodiversity hotspot. So let us look at the conditions. The first condition is that this area must contain 0.5% of world's total plant species as endemics. Now, what do we mean by that? That means that the total number of plant species that we have in the world, so which is very, very huge, 0.5% of that world's total plant species should exist in this area. So 0.5% of that huge number is also quite a huge number. So in other words, you can say that a minimum of 1,500 species of vascular plants should exist in these areas. Right? Now, why do we primarily talk about the vascular plants? That's because the vascular plants, they have the vascular tissues, xylem and phloem. And what do these vascular tissues do? They allow circulation of nutrients and water between the plant and the soil. So such plants assure great productivity to the ecosystem. So vascular plants are very much desirable for a better ecosystem. So these areas must have at least 1,500 vascular plant species or 0.5% of world's total plant species. So this is a criteria which is like a must criteria. Now, what do we mean by endemic species? Well, endemic species are those species which are kind of restricted within a very small region. Like you find those species only in a particular region of area. Now let us look at the second criteria. So the second criteria is this region must have lost at least 70% of its original habitat. Now what does this mean? So lost 70% of its original habitat means that loss of species, or this loss of species could be due to multiple reasons. Like when you say that 70% of the original habitat is lost, so why is that habitat lost? One possibility could be that the species themselves are lost. So the organisms or the animals which used to live in that region, those animals are lost. Lost means they are extinct. They do not exist anymore. So that is a possibility. So you do not have anybody to live in that area, so you actually lose that habitat. Now, what could be the reason for loss of species? Now, this can happen due to multiple of reasons. For example, destruction of forests or natural calamities like maybe change in climatic conditions. Hunting could be a major reason. Mismanagement of resources, for example, increased tourism or increased pollution, which causes environmental degradation. So basically a lot of human activities could be responsible for this loss of species and loss of habitat. So this should also be a criteria, like that region, like if you have a region which has huge variety of plant species. Let's say it has some 2,000-2,500 vascular plant species. Now, will that be called a biodiversity hotspot? Not really, because only if that region has also lost almost 70% of its original habitat, that means it would have lost huge number of species or it would have faced huge amount of destruction, because a huge area of that hotspot might have been damaged by due to some environmental calamities or due to some natural calamities. So only if that has also happened. So this shows that the area is also facing, is also under threat. That means it is threatened. So that entire region is threatened. The organisms living in that region is threatened. So only if these two criteria are satisfied. So the first criteria takes care of the fact that the region is diversified with living organisms. The second criteria ensures that the region is also threatened. So only when these two criteria are satisfied, we call a particular region as biodiversity hotspot. Now, when you talk about biodiversity hotspots, earlier some 25 terrestrial hotspots were identified. Now the number has increased to approximately 35 hotspots in the entire world. Now, if you talk about these biodiversity hotspots, one amazing fact about them is that, so if you look at their area, so area wise, all of these hotspots together, they cover 2.3% of the Earth's surface. So I am right now talking about the area covered by all the biodiversity hotspots in the world. So it covers a very small area, only 2.3% of the Earth's surface. Now, if I ask you, do you know that what percentage of the world's plant species exist in this area? That's 50%. So 50% of world's endemic plant species exist in this area. So you see, even though the area is quite small, it's only 2.3% of the total area of the Earth's surface, but the plants that exist in this area is 50% of the world's plant species. So it is so highly diverse. Again, if you talk about the animals, almost 42% of the world's terrestrial vertebrates live in these areas. So looking at this, you can get an idea that how much diverse are these hotspots. Like, they have so many varieties of plant and animal species. Now that's quite interesting. Now coming to India. So how many hotspots do we have in India? Now some of the hotspots in India are the Eastern Himalayas, where both the criteria of a hotspot are satisfied, the Western Ghats and the Indo-Burma region. So these are some of the hotspots in India. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.